Shalom and welcome to Siman Tov Torah. This year is entitled Temporary Spinners, Eternal Torah. Big fad in the whole world today is spinners, millions and millions being sold all around the world. The biggest hit, the rabbis are talking about, Shechot Shabbat, Bittul Zman, Bittul Torah, Maisev Tipshut. Lots to discuss regarding spinners. I'd like to take another point totally. Are they going to be around in another week or two or three? You're going to have stores stocked with millions of them all over the world. No one has any interest whatsoever. Or no, is it going to become like a yo-yo, like a Rubik's Cube, where it's always going to be around? So it'll go wax and wane. Where it'll have its moments, have its tukufot, its periods where they're very popular, and sometimes periods where not so popular, just the yo-yo and the Rubik's Cube and other fads. So what's the answer? We don't know. We'll see. When it comes to fads, no way to know. Depends on so many factors, and the kids, and what's in, what's cool, what's not cool, and what's interesting. So many variables involved. If we knew the answer to that question, we could make a lot of money about knowing which fad is going to be the next one and which fad is going to stay. To me, there's only one thing that we could talk about as eternal. When it comes to fads, when it comes to values, when it comes to isms and different systems of the times, they come and they go. The Torah is the only thing that's eternal. That is our anchor. That's our anchor. We have the 613 or whatever mitzvahs apply at our during our generation, and that's eternal. And it could be that there are times that there are mitzvot that lay dormant, that are not being observed properly, for no good reason. They're sleeping. The people are sleeping on the job. The klal is sleeping. But it's still in the Masorah. And you could go ahead and have a system where you have a whole group not so careful about tzniut, about covering the hair, about mixed swimming. And yet they'll still send their kids to a system where the anchor is the Shulchan Aruch. They may not even know the Shulchan Aruch that well, but there's a book called The Kids of Shulchan Aruch. Is anchored in the Masorah. And even though certain mitzvot by certain communities may not be observed so well in certain times and certain eras, it's there, the mitzvot are there, the eternal, and they're just waiting to come up again. Simple mitzvah like the Berachat HaBayit, Vel HaBayit, Yiratzon Shalev, Ashbal HaBayit, Azev, Lo B'Lam, Azev, Lo Maba. If it's centuries, it was never said. It's from the Gemara to give the full bracha, not say racham, bracha debali debali tazeh. Which is nice, add that in. But to replace the Yiratzon from the Gemara, from the Rambam, the Rif, the Rosh, Shulchan Aruch, why not do the real bracha? Why wasn't it said? Good question. Rav David Feinstein, when he publishes Agadah decades ago, he put it in. Baruch Hashem, I made a comeback. The mitzvah was always there. Some communities, in this case, many communities, for some reason weren't involved in it. The mitzvahs are there, and they're just waiting to come back again. We read in Parshas, by the numbers, for tzavah, for 20 and older. But what does that mean? A tzavah, an army, 20 and up. Who goes to the army? Who's exempt from the army? It wasn't applicable for thousands of years. Now we have our own army again. So now we have to revisit the sugya, who's obligated, who's not, who's patur, what age, is it 20 from the Gemara's time? What if you're learning? What about Levi? All these questions come back again. It's all in the Masorah. The Torah Shebichtav, the written Torah, and the Torah Shebichtav, the oral law, has all the answers, just need to mine it. So the Torah is eternal. The mitzvahs are all there. It is not chas v'shalom a fad that comes and goes. Sometimes our observance of certain mitzvot is weak in a generation. Among certain groups, among certain people, it's true. But the Masorah, it's all there, and it's only a question of time before the klal will be following all Tayag. Mitzvah Shem, Mehera, V'Yameinu. Shalom.